BO2 is one of the best trick shotting games we've ever had. It brought a unique style to trick shotting with the insta swaps, and with that came some of the best trick shots we have ever seen from the game. It's neck and neck with MW2, so today I wanted to rank the top 10 best BO2 trick shots of all time. At number 10, we have MJD. Now, this shot is just insane. He has this unique style where it's so sporadic, chaotic, and he's able to do so much in such a little amount of time, and he hits them in insane ways, insane distances, insane swings. It's just crazy, and this is easily one of his best shots. Like, look at this. This is insane. Like, I was looking back at this, and I was just like, wow, like, it's kind of crazy he was able to do all that fast. So this is an easy top 10 spot. At number 9, we have Zymzys. Now, Zymzys is probably most people's favorite BO2 trick shotter ever, and is well deserved, but this shot right here is just insane. Like, to be able to hit such a crazy shot like that with the complexity, and the steel ladder itself is such an insane spot. It's probably like mashed up with like legend ladder, almost that legend ladder. Legend ladder is still better, but is like that kind of saddest though, and to be able to hit it at this distance as well, ah, that is so insane. Definitely deserves the number 9 spot. At number 8, we have Avia. Now, this is probably one of the most iconic BO2 trick shots of all time, and it's because how is this wall bangable? Like, what? Like, and two, why would you ever go for this? This makes absolutely, why would you ever think this was ever possible? And the fact that probably the one time he ever tried it, he hit it, is insane. And everyone knows the shot. The only reason why it's not higher is because I just feel like it's just luck, and like, it comes out of nowhere. There's people who've done really more creative shots and more complex shots. This is just really cool, really iconic, and it definitely deserves the number 8 spot. At number 7, we have Refuse. I feel like a lot of people don't remember the shot, but this was one of the first, if not the first, complex BO2 trick shots. Like, this is such an insanely clean and complex shot. Like, no one was doing this at this time at all. So, like, when this was hit, it was just, like, mind-blowing. And this is such a sick shot, definitely deserves the number 7 spot. Search and destroy. At number 6, we have Tamer. Now, this shot was hit around a month after Refuse hit the last one, but this one is way more iconic than Refuse the shot, and it's because it's more creative, it's more cleaner, and it just looks so much better, to be honest. And everyone considers this as like the start of the complex creative era, because like, once BO2 saw this shot, like, nothing, it was not the same anymore. People were going for new creative and complex stuff, and you know what, it's 100% right, because this shot is extremely iconic and deserves the number 6 spot. At number 5, we have Mayo. This is probably one of the most iconic. I know I keep saying that over and over, but BO2 has so many iconic shots. But this one is definitely up there as one of the most iconic. This was a lot of people's favorite, and it's deservingly so because it's complex distance. I don't think I've ever seen a shot more insane than this that was unset up. Because it's just so unique and creative, and also extremely complex. And look how far he is. Oh my goodness. Definitely deserves the number 5 spot. At number 4, we have Beats. Now, this is honestly one of my personal favorites, and it's because this is probably the most complex and creative trick shot we have ever seen on BO2. This is just insanity, the amount of creativity put into this shot. This would be a lot higher if the other shots just weren't like something you could never replicate, but in itself, this shot is absolutely insane and definitely deserves a number 4 spot. At number 3, we have Rez. Everyone knows this shot. This is a triple collat spawn shot. I don't think we've ever seen anyone hit this on BO2. This is one and only, one of one, and it's just insane that this clip even exists. And people might be surprised this is not number 1, but the only reason why this is not number 1 is because I just feel like it loses some points, like, compared to the best. It loses some points because it's not a kill cam. It's just like, it's a mid game. There's 6 people on the map. So like, the probabilities is not the same. So I just think the other 2 clips are better. But this one definitely deserves as one of the best clips ever hit on BO2. And it just so happened to hit the number 3 spot.
Reg. Oh!
At number two, we have FaZe Linksy's Collat trick shot. Wow, like, so I guess what I'm trying to say is that a triple Collat spawn shot is less valuable than a Collat's kill cam. And yes, it absolutely is. Two people on the map versus six people on the map, and for final kill cam, this is absolutely insane. I don't even think he knew they were there. It was completely random, just as random as the Rez one, and it was a kill cam, a Collat kill cam. This is insane, unset up. Wow, oh my goodness, how could anything beat this? Nah, but there's one that beats this, but this deserves the number two spot. At number one, we have Antis. Now, if you haven't been around when this shot was hit, let me explain to you why this deserves the number one spot. At the time, BO2 was out for a few months, and people really didn't understand how to trick shot in the game yet. We kept trying to replicate MW2 trick shotting, which nowadays we know that is not what you're supposed to do on BO2. And everyone was just going for like peace swaps or just something like really simple and easy and trying their best to make it look like MW2 trick shots. This was the pioneer trick shot that changed everything. This is the trick shot that introduced us to how to trick shot on BO2. This is levels above everyone else what they were going for at this time. This was absolutely insane, and this deserves the number one spot. Let me know what you think. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Would you take some off or put some on? Let me know in the comments below, and I hope you guys enjoy and have a nice day.